Yani biz öyle burada tırnaklarımızı keseceğiz. Diyecek Gamze, ben sana söyle. Kesmeyecek bunu alıyorum.
Sana söylediğim bu kameraları çıkıyoruz belki.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Women's European Championships live from Baku, Azerbaijan, where it's time for the women's bronze medal game between Azerbaijan, the hosts, and Turkey. Well, it's the fifth time that these two have met, with Turkey winning on the previous four occasions, but all previous games were in the group stages. A little look at the two captains shaking hands. Toss happening just a short while ago. The winner of the toss looks like it was Azerbaijan. You'll get to have the choice on whether you serve first or receive first. And the captains have to sign the score sheets before we can get underway. That was, as I said previously, a short while ago. As we have a look at how these teams got here, Azerbaijan lost yesterday, an absolute classic against the Netherlands. They pulled it back. It was all doom and gloom in the fourth set, but an absolute run of serves got Azerbaijan back to 2-2, but the Netherlands pulled through to win 3-2 in the tiebreak. Turkey, well, it was a day to forget for them. Serbia absolutely cruising past Turkey, 3-0 in very quick time. Coach Gedetti of Turkey saying that his team were outclassed more or less from Serbia after playing so well to knock out the reigning champions Russia, but they must forget about that. Azerbaijan looking for their first medal in the European Championships. Their previous best was a fourth place in 2005. Turkey going for bronze for the third time. It's going to be fascinating, this one. Azerbaijan reliant massively on Rahimova, the opposite, who scored a staggering 38 points yesterday from the opposite position. But their core skills at times, passing and setting, letting them down. Turkey, well, Kadir scored 14 points yesterday. Bosch, the opposite, only 8, having been substituted in the second set. As we said, a day to forget for Turkey, but a day to remember in the quarterfinals against Russia. Which Turkey will show up, and actually which Azerbaijan team will show up as well, because they both go hot and cold. There is Rahimova, 38 points yesterday, dominant in offence. Serb also, when it gets going, is a force to be reckoned with, but also in the block she is frightening. There's Miriam Bosch, 8 points yesterday, not her finest performance, but it wasn't any of Turkey's or the Turkish players' finest performance either. There's libero Mamadova. Samadova, the other outside player. Yesterday the libero was wearing green for Azerbaijan. Kurda, top scorer yesterday for Turkey. Passed pretty well, but also a threat through that wing spiker position. So we have a look at the teams. Azerbaijan, you'd expect Samadova and Mamadova, number 8 and 9, to start on the outside. Mamadova should, number 12, start as the libero. Yagubova, the setter, continue from yesterday. And you should see Pozniak and Hasanova. players just working through their game serve, serving such an important part of this game. Amandova saying yesterday in the press conference that she didn't feel that her team served and blocked well enough, but you could also argue that in a game where side out is so important, Azerbaijan just did not pass well enough for long periods of the game. Looks like we're almost ready for go time here in Baku. We'll have the national anthems, we will meet the referees, and then we'll get things underway here. Should be a close one, this. I don't see either team winning this in three sets, but I have been wrong many times before. Oyuncuların dünkü maçı unutması lazım. Öyle bir maç oynanmadı. Sadece tek maç oynadığımızda ve Grozno'da yakalayacağız diye çıkmamız lazım. Azerbaijan versus Turkey. From the beautiful Baku. Saying before, Turkey have won all previous meetings between these two nations, but if yesterday's anything to go by, it's going to be close because Turkey really did not get out of first gear. But Serbia have to be many people's favourites to win this competition. They're outstanding. And they have been the whole way through the competition. Serbia, on the back of winning a silver medal in Rio 2016. Well, the Netherlands are going to have their work cut out later on. But first of all, let's stand for the national anthems. Turkey looking to bounce back from a disappointing performance yesterday. If history has anything to go by, they are the firm favourites, but I'm sure the hosts, Azerbaijan, will have something to say about that. Azerbaijan looking for their first medal in a European Championship. Turkey stand in their way. Players will shake hands. Before we meet the starting sixes. Bosch, 21, she's got long arms. Pulls her arm swing through very nicely as well, but She was hit and miss yesterday. I think she's going to be a key component, but also blocking as well. Mamadova, number 9 for Azerbaijan, is affected in offence. You can break her down in a pass, as you can the whole of this Azerbaijan team, but she's very effective when she's on the front court. So Bosch is going to have to be equal to her when she's blocking in that two position. You know with Azerbaijan that they're not going to pass great. They're going to play a fairly high game at times. When they are in system, they're so dangerous, but it's how long they can stay in system for and how consistent can they be. Turkey, on the other hand, I don't think we've seen the best of them yesterday. Azerbaijan, we did see the best of them, but only in glimpses. Referees Vladimir Simonovic, the man on the stand. It's going to be a tough game for the referees, especially now with the challenges coming in as well. Adds a little bit more pressure. It's President Aliyev from Azerbaijan. Missing some of his family that were with him yesterday. So, first team that we're going to meet. Looks like it might be Azerbaijan. It's certainly Turkey. So, Kadir starting for sure, the outside. 13, Akkum in the middle, gets a nod. Ademir will start setting, 11. Libero, Orja as well. Be interesting to see how she goes. 21 is Bosch, the opposite. So, similar team. Bosch opposite, Ademir setting, Dundar and Akkum in the middle. Asoy and Kurda on the outside. Orja plays as the libero. That man, bit of a legend of the game, Giovanni Guidetti. Not happy yesterday, very animated the whole way through, but has accepted defeat. He's happy with what he's done with his Turkish team, and getting to the Final Four is very, very good for them. But a bronze would be an exceptional performance and a very, very good competition for them. As we meet Azerbaijan, we're sure that we're going to see Varamova after scoring 38 points in that five-set game yesterday. Number two, Pozniak, the middle. 7, Hasanova, the other middle. Same middles as yesterday. Samadova on the outside. I think Mamadova will be playing outside as well. That's the one to look out for. 17, Varamova. Point scoring machine. And 12 is the libero. Mamadova as well. So there we have confirmation. Starting at 2 is the setter, Yagubova. Varamova starting at 5 opposite Samadova at 6, which means Mamadova starts at 3, and then the middles are Hasanova and Pozniak. There's the coach, Garyev, who gets a little bit excited watching his team play. That's maybe an understatement. It was very interesting watching the coaches yesterday. Coach Morrison from the Netherlands, very calm, giving answers, trying to problem solve. Garyev, the opposite, pointing the finger, blaming players at certain times. Some would argue that maybe adding a bit of pressure, but also helped steer the comeback in the fourth set, where they're very impressive, Azerbaijan, when everyone thought that they were buried in this game. Turkey with the serve. Mamadova hitting the first ball, and she spatches it well and truly out. Bosch, they're going to need a big performance from her today, and that's a very good start. It's a flat float serve. It's moving all over the place. It's hitting your reception quick, and it's Mamadova again that's the target. How many times are we going to see this today? Mamadova yesterday passing really struggled. It's gone off of Mamadova to Samadova. They get the middle in straight away. Excellent work from Turkey though as they go back to Bosch. But that's why Mamadova is in the team, because she's athletic, she's tall, and she makes points. Sometimes she struggles with her passing, but she contributes. Maybe she didn't get a touch on that. Maybe that's Bosch just finding the nets. In system, Turkey. Something that worked well yesterday for the Netherlands, tipping the ball over the top of the block. Cross-court block. Maybe just off the fingertips of Rahimova. She's always drifting outwards on the block, struggling to form, to get good shape pointing back into the court. Off the fingertips. 3-1 Turkey. They'll certainly be happy with this start because they didn't start well yesterday. Rahimova this time from the left side. She's an absolute cannon. They don't play the quickest to her. They keep the ball fairly high and slow, but they know that with Rahimova, she'll go over the top of everyone if they can keep the ball under control. Good slide attack too in the block. Excellent blocking from the middles. Hasanova doing her job, watching her opposite number. She sees Erdem go. She's only watching the spiker. As soon as she sees her go on the slide, she goes straight with her. Gets the block. This is a good start to this game. Back to the outside. Two in a row. Hasanova and Rahimova team up. They've got a front court setter here, Turkey, so it really only gives them two options on the front court. So they're trying to split the block by running the slide, make it tough for the middle player, and at the minute it's not working. Pozniak's doing a great job. Back to the outside. Rahimova's there again, but they do smuggle the ball through the block. Passing over. See, for anyone watching, the middle arms are not over the net, not forming, not pressing into the face of the spiker. They're more going upwards. Good setting, nice job. Pass is quite fast. It's a good pass. It's moving quickly to the net. You'd be surprised if the setter could get the ball, Yagubova, to any of the wings, but she can just stand it up, play quite quickly, play quite high through that middle period. And Hasanova started very well, but can she back it up from the baseline? Is it a rotation error or a foot fault maybe? Happy days, Rahimova doing what Rahimova does best, just cruising in, body weight's going through the ball, hits it with an audacious thud, finds the seam. It's very tough international ball for the middle blockers to close the seam. Fast passing from Turkey, great setting. And why not celebrate that one? Ademir on the reaction more than anything, just lifts the ball out to the outside. Good recovery setting. This one was always going to be close. Mamadova is the target. Her platform is quite rigid and the ball always pings off the arms quick. But she is just getting the ball in. One thing we know about Yagubova is she has to be a good recovery setter. I would say that they dig the ball, Azerbaijan, from that setting position more than they would set the ball with their hands, volley the ball out to their spikers. good angle, fading the ball away. It's quite tight, the set, so she really had to be smart there. Kurda. One in Tilda, technical. Larimova, she's hitting it from a different wavelength. She's high. Ball's nowhere near her hitting window, but somehow she gets the job done. Technical timeout, 8-7 to the hosts. Let's have a listen in. Interesting starts from Baku. No need to cry as of yet, it's early doors. That team's trading, that's what we like. Nice tempo, it's a good pass. Means the setter, Edemir, can run the game as she likes. Good work from the middle blocker, not going with the Turkish middle, but one-on-one through that center stage. And as long as you can keep the ball out of position three or at the three blocker, you go to one or to five, you've got a high percentage in international ball of winning the point. Great wiping as well, as physical as they are at times. Azerbaijan, sometimes their discipline lets them down. Bosch now serving, listening to Gadetti on the side, who's throwing some instructions her way. Uh-oh. Azerbaijan, for all their good work, sometimes they spray their first pass all over the arena. Talking of spray. Hopefully, Lukova is okay. Whatever happens, the break was good for Azerbaijan as the focus of Erdem is affected. Serves the ball far too far out the back. Good passing from Turkey, two on the front court. Looking for a touch, maybe the first challenge, maybe not going to have to challenge. Referee gives it their way. Passing better than we saw yesterday. Kurdi scoring 14 in the semi-final defeat. She's got the ball in hand now, but she started as she finished yesterday. Oh, there is a challenge. Mission Impossible music. Means there's a challenge in progress. Oh, isn't that touch? Unsuccessful challenge. Kurda gets a chance to serve. Far and over. They're serving to position 1A. To try and manipulate the pass of Mamedova, which is super inconsistent, but also to make it difficult for the setter from Azerbaijan to get the ball out to Rahimova. But as soon as they're in system, they can find a great work on the slide from Turkey. It's quick, it's wide, is beating the blockers for speed. Good work from Turkey. Been very impressed with the setter so far, Ademir. She's setting the wings well. She's used the back court attack well. Mamadova is passing back inconsistently. Rahimova has to set. That's not what Azerbaijan want. Chance for Turkey to go three in front, but there's another block. There's a little bump, so this really should go Azerbaijan's way. Rahimova, this time from the right side. Fearsome. She's high, and she hits great angles. Gidetti. Heart on his sleeve, that man. Nice defense from Azerbaijan. And Hasanova, who's sitting at five before she gets the buried off. Beautiful work. When the tip is used on the pipe, it's a quick ball, isn't it? They're trying to play so quick. Tip comes in, defense sit back. They don't even have time to adapt to that pipe ball. It's a great low set. Just showing that you don't always have to play from a high position or hit every ball. Sometimes you just have to beat the opposition for speed, especially when the team are as big as Azerbaijan. Rahimova cranks another one angle. Kurder defending one is equal to it. Poor setting from Turkey. This one has the ability to go on all day. Rahimova from the baseline this time. Bosch. See this so often. Rahimova doesn't really hit as many tembles. The libero's playing tip cover at one. Rahimova's playing at six at the moment. She played defense at one yesterday. They look to try and take her on by tipping the ball short on her at times. She's playing six at the moment, sitting in between the block. And then she's hitting the pipe ball. The pipe is used terminology when you hit the ball from the 3 meter line or behind the 3 meter line. Ace from Rahimova, 38 points yesterday. Don't be surprised if she's somewhere near that figure again today. Outstanding. Lovely work from Turkey, and I think that's where they've sided out quite well. It's a great wide sort of 3 meter quick set, finding the middle. Uthman just splitting the gap between the blocker at two and three from Azerbaijan. Slightly out of system, and they struggle to kill the ball. Mamadova is an absolute athlete out at four. Rahimova now on the tip. They do struggle a little bit more when Rahimova's on the backcourt. She struggles when the set's not in a great spot to make up for it with her feet. Bozs hits the seam, scores wonderfully well. You'll see so many times, okay, it's off the hands, but she's looking to go down the seam, as we see so many times in international volleyball. Mamadova out of system here, so use Rahimova yet again from the pipe. Good work from Azerbaijan using the middle. They haven't used the middle that much. Good blocking as well. Pozniak really coming into the game then, hitting the slide attack. Not the best blocking in the world, but not high enough from Turkey. Drifting on the block slightly, Yagubova, but no worries. Azerbaijan lead here, 16-15 at the second technical. Pozniak. Iron off. Tries a high risk set there. Ademir. Not rewarded. It's very difficult for a setter when they're out of system. Easier for Azerbaijan. They spend half their time out of system, but they have got a weapon in Rahimova and Mamedova as well, who can still polish off the attack. That's a big wipe off the block, and it gives Azerbaijan a 2-point lead. Again, the pipe successful. It's a great decision. The execution is just a little wild. Three in a row for Turkey has put them under some pressure here. Ademir again, still setting good options. The pipe against this big team is useful to use. Timeout called from Gadetti, who's going to try and pull his team back into this one. Coach Gadetti has his iPad working today. It was three in a row there for Azerbaijan. Huge for them at a big point of this game. Turkey do score. Great work to access the line there from Bosch. He didn't manage to really use his iPad yesterday. It was a bit of an onslaught from Serbia, who have looked like the strongest team in this competition. Going high off the hands. Six player can sit as deep as they like in defense, but there's no getting that. Great job again. Ademir has, and I think is a credit to Turkey's passing being better than yesterday, potentially the service pressure from Azerbaijan not being as high, but Ademir has started to run a game here that's been effective. Yes, it's not given Turkey the lead, but it's given them a chance. Over the target again. Rahimova out at four again. They go same pattern of players last time they were in this rotation. Turkey well out of sync, so it has to be a bump. Mamedova again getting involved. They go back to Rahimova. Oh, wow. No matter how you set your defense up here, whether you want the four player to come off and play on the sharp one, you've got three in the block there, Turkey. The libero at five is taking the sharp one, but there's no way you can defend that angle. Not unless you put your five player, your libero, on the sideline. And then you leave yourself two defenders playing around the block. That's an audacious attempt from Rahimova. Turkey managed to get one through the Azerbaijan wall of blockers. Bosch again screaming through the pipe. Mamedova out of system. Mamedova, the libero, getting the ball to the outside. Shut down. She's been quiet for a while, Samadova. Number eight. High, isn't she? Ackerman in the middle, just super solid. Timeout called, Azerbaijan. Внимание надо собрать сейчас. Все сделаем сейчас. Пошли, пошли. Actually a good timeout, maybe trying to upset the rhythm of the serve of Turkey. Mamadova yet again the target. She really did struggle with her passing yesterday. Back to the outside, it's high set, so two in the block. Time for the middle to get out and get formed. They spread the play again, Turkey, but good blocking from Azerbaijan have opened up the two-point lead again. The middle here doing great work. Passing over. Blocking from the right side, then having to follow the play to the left. Good disciplined form blocking. Bosch frustrated. She knows she has to put those opportunities away if Turkey want to win this first set. Right, Mava. Too easy. Again, they're trying to run the slide one way and then send it to the outside to try and disrupt the middle. Fortunately, they're out of rhythm. Tip shut down, but timeout. Let's listen to Gidetti.
I want to see one mistake diagonal. I want to see one tip linear. Enough. If not, the setter then, what do I have to get the ball? Wait, there is only you. Give setter trust. Change the Zamenko. Use the middle blocker.
When they say that, the coaches, they mean when they're running a quick play, you can try and go off the hands when you're hitting the seam and try and test out the middle blocker to see if they're in a good spot, whether they're formed and whether they're over the net in your face. It wasn't a bad play from Turkey. I mean, the middle player's gone on the reverse, trying to stretch the middle one way to get a one-on-one on the outside. International volleyball is very much about that, trying to get your hitters one-on-one with the opposing blocker. Two blockers obviously makes life a lot harder. To the outside, Rahimova raining down a bit more pain, but there's two Turkish blockers there, but they go to the opposite, and that is nice work. Bozniak this time hitting from the wing, the middle player. You see, using the middle blocker was something that Gidetti said in the timeout, but it was something that actually Azerbaijan did on that occasion. Sorry, Samadova on the right side. Middle player's drifting, so it gives you the opportunity to go off the hands. Ripper of a swing. Turkey hanging on. For the decision, and they've got it, so that's the first set point to Azerbaijan. Crowd is starting to get behind their team. Coach Garyev will be far happier than he was yesterday. Challenge says the ball is in. Could be a happy Ackman at the net. She doesn't look overly happy. Sorry, it's going to be an unhappy Ackman at the net. My mistake. Jump seven, Rahimova to steal it. That one has gone long. One set point saved. There's a change with Onal coming back in, serving to keep her team in the set. Mamadova yet again the target. She goes overhand, they go to Samadova on the outside. Great dig. Mamadova, the libero, comes in to set Rahimova, and she is shut down as well. Two set points saved from Turkey. Maybe, just maybe, they're going to get their way back into this one. Rahimova has no respect for any team's block. Akman is happy now. Timeout called, Azerbaijan. Let's have a listen in. So two set points saved. It is a bit of a limiting factor, their passing, Azerbaijan. So siding out sometimes is difficult for them when the reception in the first pass is poor. Great job from Anel coming in here for Turkey and serving strongly at the tail end of this set. Money still has to be on Azerbaijan to take the first here, surely. More poor passing, this time from Samadova. Rahimova, though, she is like a truck, isn't she? Through the middle, steamrolling through. The president is happy. The coach then will be happy. The team as well. As Azerbaijan take the first, Rahimova. Physical. Kurdit, not pressing in the block. Happy fans as well. Azerbaijan take the first set, 25-22. Long way to go in this one, though. Azerbaijan winning the first set yesterday as well, but then falling away in the second, third, and the fifth. Turkey, well, they're fast improving after yesterday's performance. It'll be interesting to see what the second set has to offer us. Set one stats. Well, the main one is that Azerbaijan lead by 1-0. More attacks from Turkey, but more errors as well. More blocks from Azerbaijan. You might expect that, considering how physical they are. Rahimova, 11 points from 18 attacks. No shock. Koda, 5 points. There's a difference, really. Rahimova, as per usual, is just on flames. It's going to be intriguing to see how Turkey can put her out as we look at some highlights from an entertaining first set here in Baku. Almost ready to get proceedings off here in the second set. Mamadova starting again. No surprises, Rahimova. Absolute point scoring machine. Pozhniak in the middle with Hasanova as well. No changes from Azerbaijan. If it's not broken, do not fix it, Coach Garayev. Kurda starting on the outside. Akman looking like she's starting again. You'd imagine that Ademir, who's set pretty well within the first game will start as well, and Bosch as well. Yagubova, the setter, looking to maybe float one in from position five. She's then going to run into position one, which is the back right position, to set up defense. Second set of this bronze medal game from Baku coming your way. Passing problems. A rare passing error from Kurdia and Turkey. I think Azerbaijan feel less pressure when they have the ball in their hand. They back themselves in blocking for sure. Can't always back themselves in their side out due to their pass. Good slide attack, quick play again, too fast. Whipping the slide attack. Again, just looking to split the block. Now that she's done that, Ademir, they can maybe look to go to the outside on that rotation, or when she's on the front court, try and get her wing spiker one-on-one. Both teams have a front court setters at the moment. High and wide from Rahimova. Rare hitting errors. You don't really ever see her make too many spiking errors. You might see her get shut down in the block once or twice, but drops her arm a little bit, looking for a touch. It's challenge time. Expecting to see Tom Cruise come down from the ceiling. Barev looks on in curiosity. No block touch. Nice from Mamedova. That's a great set. Credit where credit's due there for Yagubova. Just flips that one reverse and it's wide enough to get across Mamedova, and then she really is at her highest point coming through the ball. Now she gets a chance to serve. Whip from the baseline. Turkey sort of in system again. They can go to the wing. Great placement. Setter is sitting up on the tip. They probably know that. Mamedova, then the big figure of Mamedova, has to then take a lot of that. It's a line block, so Rahimova is potentially too inside in her line. Oh, ace from Turkey. No, great recovery. Yagubova, 10 out of 10 from you. Sloppy from Turkey, though. That was a great opportunity for them to put the point away. And now Rahimova has a chance. Big battle, this one. Samanova can only roll the ball in court, so Turkey again can only tip. Both teams having numerous chances to put the ball away. Outstanding defense from Bosch as well. More cover from Azerbaijan this time. What a rally this one is. Samadova to put the ball away. And finally, Turkey in the block find the point. Both teams putting in big, big efforts in their covering and their defensive positioning and work ethic. No seam available there. Oh, you can have such a good rally and then the next point is a shank pass. That's volleyball in a nutshell for you. It's the beauty of the game. Timeout called from Azerbaijan. Deja vu from yesterday, controlling the first set, potentially falling away in the second. Let's have a listen. Steam coming off of Garyev. No surprise there. He does have the potential to blow an absolute gasket out here today. Erdem with the serve. Free ball again. This is the Azerbaijan of yesterday. Deja vu. Win the first set. Look really comfortable. And then start to get sloppy. Substitution. Mamedova is out. She's replaced. I think. I have it over. Sorry, Aliyeva. Even that was potentially good enough, the substitution, just to break up the play and the concentration of the server. Certainly did a job that from Gariev. Standing float serve, passing from the libero. Roger is poor. So standing float serve in the middle. Maybe they have to step up a little bit here, the passing unit. Front court receiver is the target now. It does go back to the outside, Kurdit. Again, you'll see that as a tactic sometimes. They'll look to maybe serve the front court receiver. Sometimes they might serve her on her inside hand to make it very difficult for her to get out and hit anything but the line. She does hit the line on that occasion, but Rymova gets herself out of trouble. You can do that when you're that height. Ball's well inside. She can only hit one way, but she's high and she hits good angles. We know that. 38 points yesterday. Don't be surprised if it's the same again. And that's an absolute rip from Rymova. Just saying, 38 points yesterday. She is going the same way here in Baku. Some rip from the baseline. Nothing Turkey can do about that one. Just point to the line and say, yeah, that one was in. Put your crash helmets on, Turkey. Oh, another ace. Firing up the furnace, Rymova. On the front court. And now, from the baseline, Azerbaijan, after a slow start, getting back into this one. Libero Mamedova is pretty excited about it as well. More joy for Azerbaijan, but they can't put the ball away. Rymova, the substitute, just continuing. But now Rymova makes a dig as well. The set's going to be very close. Because of that, the aerial is hit. Deep breaths from Turkey. They're hanging on here as we hit the technical timeout. Tip into the aerial or the pin there.
And on the step one is for number seven. We stay in front, we can set every ball, she can help, and we go. Heidi.
Heidi, hey,
be the blocker. When you see Raimo...
Rymova passing way out of system, but she does well to hit herself out of trouble. Didn't really have any other option there, Yagubova. But in a team of physical weapons, Rymova does give Azerbaijan something different. They can play a little bit quicker to her. She's a little bit more agile. She's a little bit more dynamic as opposed to Mamadova and Co. on the front court. Higher play too in the block. They slow the play down nicely, the blockers from Azerbaijan, and then they get a chance to run the little slide attack through Pozhniak. They're growing again here, Azerbaijan. They'll be happy about this. Quick play, almost taking or just face off. Nothing the libero can do there. Twenty spikes turned to 21 for Turkey with another kill this time. Bosch. Game this one already at 45 minutes. Off the net, Mamadova trying to hit big angles. Defense is equal to it. It's again tight to the net, but it's a great set actually. Beautiful work. Gonchurik chewing through that one. Great footwork from the setter Ademir to get round that one, get it out to the wing. With the serve. It's always a balance at this level whether teams go for their serves, try and get them out of system, because if you serve lightly and all you think about is getting the ball in, it's going to make it very difficult to make blocks or digs. Ripper again, 13 on fire out there. Gonchurik. Two in a row for her. We've seen her hit that angle twice. Middle's still on court from Pozhniak. She's going to be libero'd off now. You know with the middle player that she's not going to be as good in defense. Maybe that was a reason of going there, but actually I think it was just a tempo play. Play it out there quick. Get in between the block. Higher play, three in the block against Mamadova. She doesn't mind, she'll go through it if you're not formed. Just keep crushing away. Doesn't matter how many you have in the block, if you're late and you're not pressing, you're gonna get punished. Good passing from Turkey. Can run what they like from there. It's full stretch to the left-hand side. At that height, ball that just hangs in there on the pass makes it so nice for the setter. The ball's light. You can dictate the ball whatever direction you like. You can run your offense at the tempo that you want to. Good work from Turkey. Good passing again, this time from Azerbaijan and Baramova. She's in far too early though, Baramova, so she can only just have a little chip at that one. But when you've got three big blockers on the front court at the same time, you're always going to pose a threat. That's a big wall that Azerbaijan are putting up for Turkey. And you're not allowed in. Again, given the ball, she's only hitting angle from that side majority of the time. But as soon as she does, and they do apply any pressure, it doesn't have to be a kill here from Azerbaijan. Their blocking is so good at the moment. The middles have got good speed getting out and making sure there's two blockers on the outside. Look at that. Hasanova is in a great spot there. She's pressing, she's high, shadowing over the top of the spiker. Doesn't always have to be a kill. As soon as they put pressure on in their own offense, they take the middle out of the game from the opposition, they really do have a chance. Good work from Turkey. Raramova now chasing after this one, trying to get set to Mamadova. She's out of system, so she does well just to drop the ball into one. But good enough from Turkey to run the ball wide and hit the line. panic stations as they thought that it was given against them. They like doing that, don't they? The defence of Azerbaijan. Yagubova just moving very late from the line inside to cover the tip. Ooh, we have a challenge. Looks pretty in, doesn't it? Challenge wasted. Azerbaijan. Out of system again. The setter cannot really go anywhere else but fall. Ackman gets a good sniff of that. She gets out there. She gets a good finish position and she makes the block. Enjoyable stuff. It's passing again that's letting Azerbaijan down here. Out of system. They can hit their way out of trouble. That's one good thing about being a physical team. They can kill the ball from absolutely anywhere. Surely now's got to be a chance. Rahimova. No, they go to Barham over on the outside. This time she gets through the middle blocker, but great cover from Ademir. Third time lucky maybe for Azerbaijan with Rahim over. She does just hit another sharp angle. Gadetti's disappointed. I think he wanted Ademir playing position one on defence to sit round more on a sharper angle. Feels that she should have got that one. She's not there. Unfortunately for Turkey, they lose the point. Rahim over has hit three or four obscene angles. Good reply though from Turkey. So a ripper. 16-14, 2-point lead as we go into the technical timeout here in Baku. Jump float serve to start things off again after the technical. Good passing, Barimova, she gets the ball back. They've spread the play really nicely there. Saying when Azerbaijan pass well with the physicality that they have, they really can cause problems for anyone. Barimova now with the serve, it goes deep to position one. It's an excellent pass though from Turkey. Pozniak. High, but not just sealing and closing the block back to the middle of the court. I still fancy their chances in this second set though. Azerbaijan, there's no surprise they can get back into this. Mamadova, maybe there's a net touch. No, there's not. Slow work by the setter as well. Under a little bit of pressure, just does well to guide that ball out to the outside. Mamadova, she's got a height advantage. It's one thing that this Azerbaijan side will do to you. They will hit over the top of you just because they play from such a big height. Mamadova and Rahimova especially. They're playing quicker, Turkey. They know who's at position one. They know that they can tip the ball, and as much as a threat as Rahimova is on the backcourt, look at that, she stood up, she's going backwards. Anything short on her, she's not getting the same as yesterday. Something that can be identified by any opposing coach. More quicker place the outside. Good work from the blockers. Mamadova, who went over the top last time, ball wasn't in the same airspace, it was much lower. Brought the blockers into the game. Timeout, Azerbaijan. Pressure's back on Gariev and the team in green, the hosts. Serving Mamadova, just as the Netherlands did yesterday. They've identified their target for the majority of the time here. She snatches it at the balls, too close to the body on the platform. It's going to go her way again. No, it's not. It falls inside. Rahimova with a great pass. Good work from the middle, try and find that angle back. Just a whip to the sideline. Tinova's been impressive. She didn't get much of the ball yesterday because the pass of Azerbaijan wasn't good enough, but today she's getting more and she's just showing how effective she is. Kubova whipping one in now. Sketchy passing again, this time from Turkey. It's that girl again, Hasanova. 2-2 for the middle player from Azerbaijan, and all of a sudden they're getting a bit of a sniff of this one, aren't they? The sweaty figure of Gariev starting to believe the hype as well. Great slide, good reply to keep a 3-point gap. Beautiful setting. Ademir splitting the block again. You're seeing this a lot within this game, women's volleyball in general. Front court setter, they have to split the block. Potentially can use the pipe there as well as the middle option. Also a second touch to keep the middle player interested in what you're doing. Good reply from Azerbaijan. Sorry, that one was out. My mistake, I thought it was in. Mamadova this time trying to whip one back to the line, but she goes far too long. 4-point game. Looks like we're going 1-1 here in this bronze medal game. Not if Rahimova has anything to do with it. Bonuses now for Azerbaijan is that Rahimova is on the front court. So the opportunities, the opportunity to get more blocks goes up. Mamadova is a strong server as well. If she can keep the ball in, if she can. They keep the ball away from Rahimova's block, Turkey. They get a second chance, so they do go to flirt with that block. Good opportunity to take it on. They do take it on, and the ball's hit the floor, but Azerbaijan might challenge this because they're suggesting the pancake, the hand was on the floor. If the hand's on the floor, the referee is having the final say for sure. This is a good angle to show us. Rahimova is certain. You can tell so much as a referee from the player's reaction, because it's either gonna have a bit of a guilty look on her face or she's gonna kick off like Rahimova did. Threw her toys well and truly out of the plan. They don't go to her, they go back to Rahimova. She's shut down, but there is a net touch as well. Lucky for Azerbaijan. Curdy getting caught on the way down. Service specialist Abebova to float one to the Turkish reception. It's not the best service, a very good pass. It's in the middle of the court, which is sometimes seen as a bit of a sinful thing to do in volleyball. Rahimova's block once again is a target to wipe off, as much as she's a very influential player. She does get wiped off a fair amount. First set point saved by Azerbaijan. Not saved, but given away from on our own Turkey, actually. Second set to Turkey. They've battled hard, and it's just another showing of the inconsistencies of Azerbaijan. They were hot first set, physicality, but Turkey, like the Netherlands yesterday, are proving to be more consistent throughout their passing especially. That's getting them back into this game. 1-1, more aces from the hosts, more errors from the hosts, consistency, same amount of blocks, that's huge. Turkey are actually going off the block quite nicely throughout this game. Azerbaijan need to make more kill blocks. It's one of the strengths of this team, or something as they perceive as the strengths of this team. Best scorers, Rahimova, scores more points per game than a lot of players score in their entire life. 38 yesterday, already on 17 today. Curdir on 11. Let's have a look at some highlights. Welcome back for set three. Will Azerbaijan start to find their rhythm again? There's nothing really between these two. Azerbaijan weren't at their best throughout that set, but also they were still better than they were against the Netherlands yesterday. They won't be feeling too disheartened. We always knew this one was going to be a close one, and we could all be sat here for the long haul. You're on telly, mate. Keep waving. So I'm not quite as excited to be on the big screen in the arena. Set three, Turkey, led by Gidetti, will be slightly happier with what he's seeing. Onawa's done well. She's jump float serve. Oh, what a start that one is. I think that's in all three sets we've seen a passing. Well, it's been a good serve, but also a passing error to back it up. Rahimova in five starting again on the outside. Smiles all round for Turkey. Azerbaijan yesterday completely fell apart after losing the second set, and we didn't really see them again until the end of the fourth. For everybody's sake, they would not want that to happen again. Well, Turkey obviously would, but coach Garriev would not want his health tested yet again because of that great pipe work. Rahimova, the absolute brute this time, coming back to the party through the middle. She swings from the right, she swings from the left, and then we see her also an absolute weapon through the pipe. Three in the block, just hits an angle that libero isn't getting. Again, the pipe attack, hitting towards five, hitting towards one, staying out the center of the court all the time. Out of system, Turkey, chance for Azerbaijan. Rahimova, she's in slightly too early. Can't put that one to the floor. Back again to the right side, more tips this time. The ball can't get in the slot, can't get in the hitting window. Someone has to put this ball away, come on. A little bit of physicality, please. There is, but it's not rewarded. Three in the Turkish block. Big rally, Mamedova is shut down. Gentrek getting rewarded for making the effort to get three in the block. We've seen Mamedova, she loves that sharp angle between four and five over this weekend. The third blocker can get across, it really does stop at that angle if they're disciplined. Great tip. Teams are trading, really not a lot between these two. Really has been effective within this game. Again, front court setter, they're running the middle on the slide. You can almost tell what they're going to do because it doesn't matter. You don't have to be secretive with it. You're trying to make life hard for their middle player and get your outside, or your middle player in this aspect, but two players hitting on the outside one-on-one. High roller, just a continuation. Chance again for Rahimova on the right. Two in the block. Rahimova's shut down. Turkey, if they can get at Rahimova and make her suffer, maybe take her confidence away from her, they're going to be right in this game. Rahimova is the one that Turkey need to stop, and she hasn't started this set that well. Don't know what Turkey are looking for here, maybe a touch, but the ball was well out. Libero Mamedova leaves. There is a challenge from my position. That ball looked out by an absolute country mile, but yeah, maybe not quite a mile, but it's missed by some distance. What a waste of a challenge. Abdul Zimova is in. She's not in for very long. Libero comes in to replace her. She's very much a bit of the heartbeat of this team, the libero for Azerbaijan. She keeps talking, keeps leading. Better passing. Rahimova's in a far better spot. When that ball's in her hitting window, she is too high. She gets caught leaning in, hitting the ball from her left side, sometimes too many times. When that ball's across her, she's so high it's hard to stop. Points for days. Celebrations for Turkey because they know that they've just got one of the main servers from the Azerbaijan roster off the back line. 10th passing again, but it's in a fairly comfortable position for the setter. No chance to side out. Oh, Mama Dova. Full stretch. Gentrek's being very strong for Turkey in that wing spiking position. Athletic, high, constantly a cannon hitting angle. Mamadova again rigid in the pass, but she just scoops it in somehow. Back to Gentrek on the outside. This time she goes off the block. Bit of pinball between the blocker and the defender. Second chance to go to the middle. It's a great angle. She might just miss out. Ackman. It's no surprise. She's trying to avoid the blocker. So for any young middle player, they have to hit these angles again to one, try and beat her across her body or snap it back. No real drama. It wasn't a bad play from Turkey. It just missed out. They're going to have a little challenge anyway. Let's have a look. Have another look for Tom. Oh, it is out. Better. Once again, Gentrek has come in and she's just provided stability today. Didn't play that much yesterday, but she loves hitting that angle. Deep cross court. Mamadova stepping up very high. Technical timeout. Let's have a listen to Guidetti. Kids are having a great time. Volleyball in Azerbaijan is a growing sport for sure. A very good indoor league. Rahimova, the star of Azerbaijan volleyball. It's been entertaining, that's for sure. And it's only the bronze game. Serbia and the Netherlands should be an absolute ripper later on. Back to business. Kalishkan with a little jump float serve to get us underway again. Mamadova the target. Great passing from the libero. Opens up everything. The set's quite low. Gentrek again, 13, leading this team here. Look at the finishing position. The left arm coming round, the right arm pressing as well. Very good for any young blocker. Everything looking back into court. There's no getting past it. There's no tooling. And there's a great serve as well. The technical timeout has not done anything for Azerbaijan. And it looks like they're going to have to call another one. 10-5. Float serves dipping all the time. Mamadova is very deep, can't get her shoulders underneath it, can't get a good platform on the ball, ends up steering the ball between Pozniaku's footwork. Wasn't quick enough. Here we go. He's not happy, is he? Azerbaijan looking for their first medal of the European Championships ever. Started well both days of this final four, but consistency, especially in the past, has absolutely crucified them at times. Good timeout though, something you see very often, timeout just killing the concentration and the momentum of the server. Great job, Mark. When she can go off happy, but it's just must be frustrating for a coach post timeout to see him as serve. Good passing again. Turkey is starting to pass well. Look who it is again. I don't know how Azerbaijan are not maybe putting a defender back a bit deeper on that angle, because I'm telling you, sort of 80-90% of the swings from Gentrek is in that sort of area, that deep angle position. Middle player is always reaching, leaning, she's late. You just think that the libero maybe would just sit deeper and just absorb that that angle, but no. Mamadova, oh, just long. Turkey is sure they deserve that one. They take it on the scoreboard on your screen, but I'm sure the referee gave that to Azerbaijan. No, my mistake. It was Turkey that take the point. Azerbaijan falling apart, as we saw yesterday. Similar story. Pipe Rahimova on the backcourt. Now they've got into her head as well. Her feet nowhere near the ball, really. Her arm always operating too far away from her body. You'll see here. Have to keep that arm pulling through into your pocket. Timeout, Azerbaijan. The Turkish coach, Gagetti, will be very happy. Let's have a look at Gariev. Oh, he's not happy. Looks like they've all been summoned by the school teacher. Over stopped yet again. They run the slide, as we've seen so many times. Erden, this time the ball travelling a little bit too far across her, so she can only whip it back, but she can whip it the wrong side of the sideline. Bit more joy for Azerbaijan. There's still a bit of work to do for him at this moment in time. Can't really afford that. Granted, you have to be aggressive with your serves when you're 6 points down, but you can't afford to go into the net. Out the back, maybe a little bit more acceptable. There's a chance that they might leave it. There's a chance there might be a touch somewhere along the line, but not in the net. Trying to tip off Rahimova. She's a big unit. She gets the ball back. Great covering of the line from Mamadova. Now a chance for the other Mamadova to get a swing away, but she's dug really well back for Turkey. Oh, Tomahawk defense has maybe a handover from Erdem. It is a handover. Erdem is not happy about that. She knows that that's her mistake, really. Six-point game. Well found. Kadir gets her feet to a good spot, then whips it back to the line. High game. Poor blocking, really, from Azerbaijan as well, and defense. Blockers leaving big gaps. It's so high. They're so out of system. Now it's Azerbaijan here out of the system. Rahimova, is she going to be able to find the floor here? No. She does well to get the attack away, though. We'll give her that. She gets a second chance. Dug again. Chance on the counter for Turkey. Off the block of Rahimova. Rahimova is struggling. Azerbaijan is struggling. 16-8 to Turkey going into the second technical timeout here in Baku. At the moment, it looks as if Turkey are the favourites to win this bronze medal. They've won every game between these two teams. Let's have a look at Gariev now. Let's see if he's cheered up. Thank you. Turkey with all the momentum. Only two from the last 10 for Azerbaijan, not good enough. Side out percentage far too low. Through the pipe, great work from Turkey, absolutely dictating everything. Tempo's good, timing of the spike is good as well. Ademir's playing very well, just orchestrating all the attacks. The setter. Serving to one. Rahimova again getting touched. She's got two. That's a better bit of defense. Sits around well there, the Turkish defender, and then they go off the block yet again. Rahimova is really suffering in here. We haven't seen her put the ball away for a long time, and we've also seen Turkey go off the block three, four, five times as well. So she's coming off. Can't believe it. Rahimova, who scored 38 points yesterday. The weapon of this team has been taken off. Maybe saved, maybe she's feeling tired. She gets set. Such a large proportion of balls within this team, and it's been a long week for them here. Maybe she's just starting to run out of gas. Rahimova making the most of some funky blocking positions from the Turkish middle. Oh, ripper. Achman getting width, beating the block down the line. Great slide attack. Recover from Ademir, the setter. I mean, she can't set the ball, but they do well to get the ball away. Anyway, Turkey, they are commanding everything here. Kulan, the reserve opposite, doing a job as well in there. Good work from her. It's tough. She's a very good player, Kulan, who gets limited opportunities in this team because of Rahimova. One-on-one. Bosch shut down, trying to hit angle. Rahimova. Exemplary stuff from her. 1 point back, still nine behind though here, Azerbaijan. Communication problems for Turkey. Great out of system swing, all the same from Bosch, this time from the left side. Chance for Rahimova though, and we're back to eight. Maybe there's just a small chance for Azerbaijan to get their way back into this one. If not, confidence is key. That's a menacing swing down the line. Oh, good counter though. Point goes the way of Azerbaijan. Not quite sure why. Maybe a net touch. But doesn't look like any of the Turkish team are quite sure why either. Kurdir pleading innocence here. I'm not sure whether Turkey have another challenge or not. Doesn't look like it was Kurdir who hit the net. Back to seven. This one's coming back slowly. Middle's back in the game, but they're equal to it. Poor touch. Have to have a bit of empathy there, though, for Mamadova. She's coming in to try and get that tip. Wasn't expecting a touch from the middle blocker. Her momentum's always already going forward just there. She's already going forward to that first tip, and it means she just deflects the ball out the back of the court. Kurdia getting booed now by the locals. Front court receiver. Rips angle with some, very difficult to do that from there. Second ball, sly attack, no joy. Rahimova, second time in this rally, second time she wants to hit away from the body onto the angle. She does find the point eventually for Azerbaijan. They're getting better again here. They had a poor period throughout the beginning of this third, and whatever happens, whether they can get back into this set, as they did yesterday against the Netherlands, they had a bit of a smash and grab from being in a similar position. They do back themselves when their back's against the wall. And they've got Genturek nailed down as well. We said earlier, didn't we, she loves hitting that same angle every time. Sort of deep five. They're equal to it now, Azerbaijan. Maybe there is a chance for them. Bosch off the block and out of play. Salvaged one there, Turkey. They might be seven in front, but they've not had the best of this game throughout the last 5 minutes or so. Poor passing, maybe they get away with it. Genturek fiddles one through the block. Vukubova. This is a good server at this time for Turkey, just to try and wrap things up. She served well. It's that flat float serve again that puts Mamadeva under some pressure. Looks like Rahmova's back in the game, this time on the pipe attack. Sorry, it wasn't. It was definitely still Kulan. Consistency going up from Turkey again. It's been effective out there on the opposite, the Bosch. Two more for Turkey to cruise into a 2-1 lead. Quicker, better pass. Two balls used, but that's good agility shown from the Turkish middle, but good reactions from Mamadova, the libero. Another chance, they go back to Bosch. She goes off the block again. I think that one might be out as well. She's tooled to the right sideline, now to the left. Azerbaijan are well aware that that's gone out of play. They might argue the call. Looks like four or five coverers from Turkey were all stood up far too high, but they get away with it. As you said, good serving. Genturek now serving to go 2-1 up. Ace! She's picked on Mamadova numerous times short. She gets rewarded. Turkey take the third. They're 2-1 in front here. And that was fairly easy for Gudetti and his team. After winning the first one, 25-22, they've lost the next two, Azerbaijan, 25-21, 21-14. Turkey are starting to go well here. Some stats. Three aces for Turkey. Service pressure is key in this game. More attacks as well. The side out percentage, not good enough for Azerbaijan here. Rahmova, still the danger. Percentages are not high, but let's have a look at some highlights from what is turning out to be a highly entertaining bronze medal game here from Baku. looks as if it's the same as with Jean Tiemers yesterday, starting well and then just slowly capitulating for a while before potentially getting back on course, but who knows what's coming our way with this Azerbaijan team. Sometimes it's electric, sometimes slightly more painful. Yakubova. Rahimova means she's got maximum amount of rotations on the front court, irrelevant when you serve into the net. This is a frustrating time for Azerbaijan. They're looking for their first medal, and really the way that they started, they probably a few people's favourites. Rahimova absolutely unstoppable, but now they're in struggle city. Blocking the highest calibre, big hugs. They know what you'll find here is Turkey will know how important this first 5-6 points of the game is, because they can really shut Azerbaijan down psychologically, get under their skin. And now kissing the ball, it's probably quite sweaty, she doesn't mind. More good serving, Mamedova. Service target again, standing shot now from Azerbaijan, but just too good from Turkey. They're going after Mamedova, same as yesterday, inconsistent with the pass. There's no middle player, front court setter. The middle is already looking at that slide attack from the Turkish middle player going around the back. The setter knows this, makes a good decision, makes a point. Better passing from Mamedova. This time, Rahimova has got a free swing at it, but she's dug. It's good positioning. Deep on the back line from the sixth player from Turkey. Second chance, Rahimova. She goes high off the block again. They slow the play down, though, the blockers. Now a chance on the counter. Taken by Turkey. Mamedova frustrated. She doesn't close the angle on the block. The ball goes flying out the side. Positioning, persistence, and placement pays off for Turkey. Time out already. Four in a row. No surprises for Beriev. Is the timeout going to have any effect on his players? Potentially a missed serve from Turkey. No, good concentration this time, good focus. High to Rahimova, same old story. They're equal to it, Turkey. Chance for a fifth, great angle on the slide, chopping it straight the way, straight back across the front of the court. Mamedova's not getting back to play defense there. The sixth player is sat so, so high. Phenomenal work from Turkey so far. Better from Rahimova this time. Can't keep going to Rahimova. Out at four. As much as she's the engine of this team, she's not scoring at the moment. Again on the pipe attack. Great example for any youngster watching. Hitting those angles deep to five or deep to one. Way out of system. Rahimova's trying to up the ante here from Azerbaijan. They've not been good enough in the last two sets. They haven't started well either. Mamedova needs to find a spark from behind. Better from Orji, the libero, who's She's not had so much to do today, the libero from Turkey, but what she has done has been a lot more consistent, a lot better, and it's allowed Ademir to really dictate this game as setter, run her plays, do what she wants to do. I'm over again, this time on the left side. More errors from Azerbaijan. Their dreams of gold were taken away yesterday. Now their dreams of bronze potentially gone as well. Mamedova again showing how vulnerable she can be on the pass. Just leans into that one, throws her arms at it. Nowhere in a million years is she going to create an angle from her arms to a target there. Technical timeout, let's listen in.
Stay right feet on 3 meters. Just don't come inside. Stay outside. This, okay? Then, number five, you stay outside the block. Quick ball, Sasa. High ball, Lina.
Libero being asked to just sit outside the block, hoping that we think the middle blocker will do their job. Depends which side she's blocking, to be honest. If she's sat at five and the opposition go to four, she has to sit outside the middle blocker. If she's defending the line at five, she has to sit outside her own outside hitter. You think he's on about when the ball goes to four to Raranova. Look at that. Not good, is it, from Azerbaijan, really? Better. When was the last time we've seen a successful middle attack from Azerbaijan team? Hasanova has been exceptional through that middle section of the court. Every time she's been asked to do something, she's done a great job of it, but they just can't keep the service to her because of the passing. Joy, no closure on the Azerbaijan block. Gets smuggled down the front of the blockers. Too slow from Pozniak. Well, from both. Credit to the setter. Maybe that's what Coach Galetti was on about. They can't put the ball away there, Turkey, but they do get the dig because it was actually the middle player from Turkey sat on the outside of the block. Better from Azerbaijan though, starting to apply more pressure. Ooh, challenge time in set four. First challenge that we've seen in this set. Looking for a block touch. Does go to Azerbaijan, but Turkey get one straight back. They've had an answer to everything. I think even though Azerbaijan at times have got better and more consistent, Turkey have had good clutch out there today. They've stayed calm under pressure. Still got a 6-point lead. It would be very surprising if this finishes any other way than 3-1 at the moment. And there's another huge block, 3 in there. Good work from Kurdi, getting over there as well to get a three stacked up. Baramova loves hitting that angle, doesn't she? Loves going cross court, and they've just taken that away from her. Baramova this target again. And what they're looking at doing is when you serve the front court receiver, it's very difficult to hit an angle back across the court. So serving the front court receiver, they're out of system a little bit. The ball goes back out. You've got three in the block. There's a good chance you're going to get yourself a block in there. No blocks that time from Azerbaijan and Turkey. She's been very good, Kirdir. 14 points yesterday. She's stacking them up yet again today. Timeout called from Azerbaijan. Running out of chances, Gariev. Setting's excellent to find Ryan over from there, but so is the dig from the libero, and then they get one smuggled over again. Habibova, not the biggest blocker on this Azerbaijan side. They're going to keep trying to go through it, go over the top of her. Pressure on the number 18 for sure. She's in here more for a passing than she is, sorry, for a setting than she is anything else. But there's a complete mismatch. She's a smaller player. Baramova, she's put down again. How many times are Turkey going to shut the door on the weapon from Azerbaijan? She had everything her own way in the opening stages of this game, but Turkey have been disciplined in their block. They've played some outstanding defense, and they're really shutting the door here on Azerbaijan. Just 4 points from 18. It's an absolute roasting outside Baramova. She can't find the floor. It's good reactions from Turkey. Another chance to go through the block. Habibova looking to the stars. Maybe Azerbaijan are going to have to start looking to themselves to fix things here, because this game is pretty much over. More tooling off the outside hand. That's why she's frustrated. Baramova wants to hit angle again. No touch off the block. 16-4. This is more of a rugby score, or potentially a basketball. Gudetti is happier than he was yesterday. He was saying last night that he felt that his team were outclassed yesterday by Serbia, which in fairness they were. But the bronze here would be a great week's work for Turkey. I think everybody would agree on that after knocking out reigning champions of Russia. Last hugs for Turkey. They know they've done 85, 90, maybe 95% of this job, but there's a bit of work to be done yet. Great angle is just wide. They might challenge though. The line judge might have given this in. They're sure, Turkey, that they should go even further. I think Mamadova's eyes, picture could say 1,000 words, that would be one more Mission Impossible. Yeah, they're right, Turkey. Mamadova, your face told us everything we needed to know anyway. issues, not stable in that first pass. Heads gone from Azerbaijan. They have gone well and truly off the boil. 18-4. Can't remember the last time I've seen an international game. It's been this, or set, sorry, not game. Azerbaijan have been strong at times. But a set that's been this one-sided is pretty dreadful from Azerbaijan. More they've gone, haven't they? They've completely gone, and Turkey are now showboating. Mamadova has sat very high for a six player. All at sea, Azerbaijan. Turkey are cracking the whip here. Substitutions, Mamadova is out. Tip taken from Orja. More points as there's a net touch. This is getting embarrassing now for Azerbaijan. Massive net touch all over it. The Azerbaijani blockers. Turkey five away. Azerbaijan finally get off of that rotation. It's been a long time coming. The pass was actually good. I say that because it's not been good for large periods. Mamadova can then spread the play to the middle player on that slide attack. Too little, too late, surely. You never know, but Turkey can afford 10 of those points and still be favourites to win this set. No pressure, but they can't drop concentration. They can't drop their focus. Ademir De Setta, who's been pretty good throughout, has oh, wow, Turkey. Come on, ladies, up the level in here. Better from Azerbaijan. They're serving because they've got, serving tough because they've got absolutely no pressure on them now, but Turkey might call a timeout here. I imagine Gedetti is going to not be seething, but he's going to be disappointed with what he's seeing, especially if they lose this one. They've lost three in a row already. Now they get one back. They're off that rotation, and they're one closer to sealing the bronze medal. From Azerbaijan, and this is just so one-sided. Turkey can almost announce on the gold. Smiles for Kurda. She's played exceptionally well this evening. Mamadova, her turn to leak a pass. Turkey, they're on autopilot. Ready to celebrate already. 23-7. The smiles all around. They know it's coming their way. Just need closure now. It's going to come very soon by the looks of it. Samadova, she's dug. Good work stacking the line there. The sixth player sitting in between the block and making a good dig. They score another one in transition. 24-7, bronze medal match. Everybody happy. Everybody throwing high fives, big smiles. I think Turkey, well, not that they're going to get too complacent, but 24-7. The subs know already that they're probably going to take bronze here. Through the middle, Rahimova, dug again. Excellent job from Kurdi, just sweeping things up. There is a block. They're going to get eight. Can they get nine, Azerbaijan? It's been a thumping. This is not the Azerbaijan that we saw yesterday. We saw them fight back in the fourth. They've fallen apart. It's been, well, they've just folded here in Baku in front of the home crowd. To the outside, is this the game? Yes, it is. Turkey take the bronze. 3-1, 25-8 in the final set. They have bullied this Azerbaijan side. Too good, too consistent. Azerbaijan started well, but went well and truly off the boil. Smiles for Turkey, potentially some tears for Azerbaijan, frustration for Gariev. Well played, President Aliyev in the crowd. Lacking a little bit of guts in the final phases. They'll be happy with a fourth though for sure, Azerbaijan, as this is the first time since 2005 they made the final four, some disappointed faces. But they can look back over a competition and be fairly happy. It's not a happy president. Last huddle for Turkey. There you have it. Turkey take the bronze after losing the first one, 22-25. It was one-way traffic from there. More shots to the president. Players clapping their leader. Smiles for Turkey. Kurdia had a great game. Ada made a setter. The pass was good. The libero, Orja, had a very good game. Let's have a look at some stats. 3-1. 62 attacks for Turkey to Azerbaijan's 36. That's unbelievable. More blocks for Turkey as well, but the attack stats there tell you everything. Rahimova, only 19 points. That's half the amount of points of yesterday. Osoy, look at that, 23. Kadar, 22. Between them, they've seen, well, with the help with the rest of the team, who are very impressive, have seen Turkey through here. There we have it. Turkey take the bronze here in Baku. We're going to have the Netherlands up against Serbia a little bit later on, 7 o'clock local time. That should be a thriller. Serbia winning 3-0 earlier on in the competition against the Netherlands, but they're fast improving. And after a good performance yesterday, they might fancy their chances here this evening. We're going to leave you for the time being with some replays of what was a fascinating game here in Baku.